Oh, yep. I'm just about to, I'm just gonna hang on. He roasted it. I still haven't gained any line on him. He's down there just freaking out in that fast, shallow water. Just wallowing around like a big pig. Oh, sweet. River rats, I showed up at the river with no bait, no food, and fortunately was able to get a little bit of both. I'm still planning on staying here the entire night, and we'll see what we can catch. So let's go. Okay, I should probably watch where I'm going. Probably the safe thing to do. Not the exciting thing to do. Probably the smart thing to do. Anyway, we floated about 4 or 5 miles and I'm gonna say we got 6 or 7 to go. I don't know, it's a ways to go. It's far enough. The wind's finally died down, which is really nice. Holy crap, is that a lot of shad. The bottom is like pure shad. At least I would assume those are shad. We have some shad. No shad that big. We're still gonna throw them at some brush and rocks and other little cover features and see if we can catch something. I'm excited to camp. It's been a while since I've kayak camped. I enjoy the like tranquility and peacefulness of it. And could camp at this spot, but there's already some campfires here. Feels tainted. Might be a little excessive. I'm gonna fish some timber. This is like some deep timber, but I don't know, I'm just not feeling it. But it's such classic flathead habitat that I gotta give it a little bit of a try. And the worst thing that's gonna happen is I don't catch anything, so give it 10, 15 minutes and move on. Something weird happened there. Kinda thinking something pulled my bait in this snag. A little too bouncy to be a flathead. For a second I thought it might be. Either a little channel cat or a gar. That's my guess. Let's see what my bait looks like. I think we have a gar or a turtle. Not the target species. Can I stop? Kinda. There. That sucks. I think that would have been a good spot to catch a channel cat or something. Fast rocks, you never know what'll show up in a spot like this. Only a foot deep, I guess. There could still be some fish here. It's evening. Not too far from where I'm gonna camp at. Probably got a little over an hour of daylight left, but that's enough time to hit a spot or two on the way down, I think. Might be proven wrong. Definitely one spot though. Is this the spot I want to hit? That part I'm not sure. There's probably some fish in here, but I think we're gonna keep moving. We got some fast water here though. Fast water. Lots of times means catfish. Not all the time. Sometimes it's the opposite, but I'm gonna bet this time it means catfish. Not saying we're gonna get one. but I bet we get one. You want to know the you want to know the bait I'm using? Got some fresh gizzard shad. By fresh, I mean I caught it like 45 minutes ago. I'm just dicing it up into little chunks. Got her on a 5-aught kale style hook. I like rattles, at least for blues and channels. Flatheads sometimes like them. Sometimes they could care less. Yeah, warm water, warm weather. I like a rattle for channel cats and blue cats quite a bit. Even cold weather, pretty much always have one on when I'm fishing for them rascals. I'm gonna try and send this. That was off target, so we'll let her sit there, see what happens. Not for long though, because if there's one here, he's probably gonna take a swipe at it pretty quick. There's actually some decent depth in there, so a big old whammo would be sweet. Nope, we're getting a bite. Pull her down, buddy. Oh, that was more excited. Ooh, got one here now. Come on, catfish, don't make me a liar. Stuff here. Pull her down. Yep. Oh. Oh, there we go. It's like, how'd I miss him? But wow, what are you? Are you a catfish? Wow. He's an angry catfish. I'm wondering if it's a hybrid. So fast. If he's a hybrid, he's a big hybrid. I think he's a cat. Oh, he's running at me now. There's a lot of current there too. Ooh, oh, there's a log there. Oh, he's got that rod game. Oh yeah, dandy Chan. Fast water. Oh, we're gonna double. Oh dang, we still might double. Oh, there's a squirrel over there. It is squirrel season, buddy, be careful. Lucky I'm not armed. Yeah, a lot of power in this dude. Plus I'm geared up to have fun catching him. Jeez. Oh, he's running upriver. Oh yeah, you are, Dave. Grippers, come here, grippers. I wanna see you. Couldn't tell how well he was hooked. Open your mouth. Oh yeah, fast water, he liked it. It's where they come when they're ready to mow down food, and he mowed down food quite effectively. That was fun. All right, back you go, amigo. Man, he fought awesome. I think we should try to do that again. That was too much fun not to. You know, there's a lot of people that don't think very highly of the old channel rat. And channel rat is, oh, you know, you pick on your buddies because you like them. You give them mean nicknames and stuff. It's kind of channel rats for me. The only time I don't like them is if I'm trying to catch a flathead and they kill my live baits. But other than that, pound for pound, they are without a doubt the toughest catfish out there. And when you fish for them with appropriate tackle, they're a blast. Like, these are medium rods. These are 100 size bait casters. Oh, already got bit. And, I have some heavier line because I'll do double duty as like light action flathead rods. So they got 50 pound braid main line. Then I can play with the leader. Like from channel cat fishing, I'll use 20 or 30 pound leader. Not that you need something that heavy, but you go lighter, you have to retie a lot more. So yeah, I really like 30 because you don't have to retie all the time. And if you do hook a flathead, you got something a little more zip to it. Handle that bigger fish. And actually tonight, I got one with 60 pound leader on it that I've been dipping close to structure. And tonight I'll switch the other one to 60 pound too. That way I'm ready if a big duke hits. I guess something's still messing with that, I think, or it's tangled, or on a log, or I don't know. We have it 10 minutes, maybe 5. Oh, there he goes. He liked it, he didn't love it. Thing about getting different reels, I like the line counters, but these are just a little small and I'm using them for a little bit heavier duty than what they're designed for. Might go the next size bigger, or I might just use them till they fall apart. If I keep catching these channel rats, pull it down, buddy. Right there. Do it. Maybe. Sounds dorky, but sure is pretty this evening. Oh, yep. I'm just about to, I'm just gonna hang on. He roasted it. I still haven't gained any line on him. He's down there just freaking out in that fast, shallow water. Oh man. Just wallowing around like a big pig. Oh, sweet. Yeah, run at me, buddy. We're gaining line now. Oh, got another nibbling. Just a nibble so far. And I think there's a log over here. The other one was nice enough to swim out of it. Hopefully this one does the same. Ooh, he's nice too. Come on over here, buddy. Nothing like catching mean, hard-fighting fish out of a floating piece of plastic. Oh yeah, another bruiser. Kinda got a derp face. Well, I didn't like me saying that to him, I guess. Come on. All right. Another dandy. Fought like a champ. Hit it like a champ. Guess that makes him a champ. Back in the water you go, buddy. Even with your derp face. Oh yeah, I forgot to show him. We won't show his derp face. Then I just feel like I'm picking on him. Oh. See ya. Okay, do we stay and try to catch one more? I think we need to go check out camp to, make sure everything is the way I hope it'll be. It's the next sandbar that I might want to fish is a long ways away. So let's get going. I almost turned around and paddled back up river, but this spot looks like it's got potential. I don't know, the fish will tell me what's going on, but it's a big deep hole. It's not deep here, it's like, starting to drop off. It was like 6 inches back there. Now we're in, 5 feet. Drops right off to 5. I like that. Do the fish like it? That'll be the biggest thing. But we're gonna spend the evening here and find out. I'm optimistic. Because I'm here. This is where I'm gonna be. Okay. Got everything unloaded. Could use some fresh bait. Got the big rod casted out. Sometimes these elbows are where the shads are at. Thought I saw a glimmer of something in there. What do we got? Just big baits. Got one shad in there. Could dice you up. You're a little big though. Got one shad. We'll put him out. Okay, I'm gonna try to get some more bait and get camp set up, and hopefully we'll see when we got a nibble. There's something on the end of it. I think I have it. What are you? Turtle? I have no idea, to be honest. Oh, it just popped off. It's going to adjust the camera. These bite marks make me think it was a or the lack of bite marks make me think it was a lethargic flathead. Oh well, I guess. Toss another one out. I got him. Ain't even bad. Oh, stay on, buddy. Now he's running at me. I think I know what you are. He took off fast, though. Well, I think he's still on there. I think he's all right. No way. That is not what I thought you were. Surprise. Oh, easy, bud. Oh, yeah. Easy's not your thing. Talk about a surprise. Did not expect to see Mr. Striped one, but I won't turn him down anytime. He hit it. He made that real sound, make noises I didn't know it could make when he hit it, which was pretty neat. But I'm gonna let him go, and hopefully a bunch more show up tomorrow morning. I got a rod rigged up and ready for him. Alrighty. See you, bud. Sucking on my thumb. You should be good. There he goes. Sweet. I'd be okay with catching a bunch of those. Huh. Did not expect that. Come on. Okay. Oh. This has got some mustard to him. Nope, stay on. He must have just rolled around there for a second. Oh. Stay on, buddy. Ooh. Not gonna mess with the camera on this one because I kind of want to see him. And by camera, I mean other camera, I guess. Should have clarified. Feels like the right kind, which is exciting. All right, what do we got here? Oh yeah, the right kind. Oh, he got in the other line. Impressive work, friend. You're like eater-sized even. Come here. Gotcha. Okay. Yeah. Sweet. Well, pretty good evening. Caught my two favorite fish, three if you count the channel rats earlier, and pretty happy to get this little fella. I'm gonna let him go. I've thought long and hard about eating him. I want to do a catfish comparison video on taste, but he's kind of right on the top end of what I consider a prime eater, so he's gonna go back. Hopefully we get one like 5 to 10 pound range. He's probably on that 12 to 15. See you, bud. Get big. Well, we got something going on. Very turtley. Oh. Yeah. I don't know if we got him or not. We do, he's small. I don't think we do. Well, what is it? Well, a little channel rat. That's correct. He is small. I think this is a excellent send-off for bed. We got some thunderstorms rolling through, so that might get lively. The weatherman says it shouldn't be that bad. The radar says, makes me think otherwise. We will see. I got up when the sun came up to chase hybrids, caught one. I was kind of slow and I was pretty wore out, so I went back to sleep, and we are a long ways from when the sun came up. Yes, I was a little wore out, but yeah, we need to get moving. I do feel more refreshed. Also, realized I forgot my allergy medication and a toothbrush. Roughing it. Sometimes part of roughing it is feeling a little rough. Okay, I think I got everything. Yeah, definitely do. Well, I got a ways to go and I'm gonna get going, but hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button. You know, kayak camping sure is nice. It's simple. And it's got to be, because you don't have much room. That's part of, I don't know, I like simple things. Probably because I'm simple-minded, but I'm rambling. I need to drink some more caffeine. But thanks for watching. Seriously. Hope you catch a giant.